So in a tank circuit, if a two inductor, one capacitor along with the amplifier circuit is called as a Hartley oscillator. So this is a tank circuit, so this is a feedback circuit, and this using the BJT is called as an amplifier circuit. So in a tank circuit, two inductor, one capacitor along with this amplifier is called as a Hartley oscillator. Remember, this is a feedback and this is the amplifier. Now, amplifier is using in a CE configuration. CE configuration is a common emitter, because the emitter is common for both input as well as the output. And biasing in the sense, in order to work the BJT, we are applying the DC bias, because DC is a DC voltage. So this is upfront difference of the voltage divider circuit. If the base is connected to resistors R1 and R2, such configuration is called as a voltage divider circuit. So DC bias is applied to the bias, and RFC is a radio frequency choke. So this radio frequency choke will be act like a short circuit when DC supply is applied, and open circuit when a higher frequency is applied. So here we are applied the DC, so it will work as a short circuit. Now, next. So this amplifier circuit will use a phase shift of 180 degree, and this tank circuit will use a phase shift of 180. So again, 180 degree to 180 degree, we got a 360 degree phase shift. So remember here, two inductor and one capacitor is there here. So to order to obtain a 180 degree phase shift, we have the reactance is like x1 plus x2 plus x3 should be equal to 0. Then only we get the phase shift of 180 degree. So by rearrangement, x1 plus x2 is equal to minus x3. Here x1 is taken j omega l1 because of inductor. x3 is taken j omega l2 because of x3 inductor. And x3 is taken as 1 by j omega c because of capacitor. Because inductive reactance is written as an omega l, and capacitive reactance is written by 1 by omega c. The same value is substituted here. J omega L1 plus J omega L2 is equal to minus 1 by J omega C. So here this J minus 1 by J both get cancelled. Here omega is taken common, L1 plus S2 is equal to omega C. This omega is taken to the LHS, that become omega square. L1, L2 is goes to the RHS. This is written as L equivalent. So that is L1 plus S2 is equal to L equivalent. Next, omega is equal to 1 by square root of this, and this omega can be written as 2 pi f. So only written for f is equal to, and this 2 pi is written here. So we will get the frequency of oscillation by using Hartley oscillator will be 1 divided by 2 pi into square root of L equivalent into